Today, we are going to study liquidity ratio. Liquidity ratio is also called working capital ratio. Liquidity ratio is calculated to analyze the short-term solvency of the company or organization. These ratios show the ability of the company to meet its short-term repayment activities. Under this method, two ratios are calculated: current ratio and liquid ratio. Liquid ratio is also called quick ratio and acid test ratio. According to concept, its standard ratio is 2:1. It means 2% of the assets and 1% of the liabilities. That is the best part. That means its standard ratio is 2:1. If 1:1 not able to pay creditors on time, if 3:1 capital is not being used effectively, it means working capital is not used properly. Now go for the current ratio. It is also called working capital ratio and short-term solvency ratio. According to old concept, its standard is 2:1. As I have already told, two parts of current assets and one part of current liabilities is standard. As less as inventories, liquidity is more. And its formula is current ratio is equal to current assets divided by current liabilities. Now go for an illustration. Look here, the following information is given by ABC company: cash, debtors, marketable security, creditors, bills payable, bank, advance income, bank overdraft, accrued income, prepaid expenses. These are some extracted transaction of current assets and current liabilities. From these current assets and current liabilities, we have to find out which are the current assets and which are the current liabilities. Now, go for the require. First is the current assets, then current liabilities, then current ratio, and then working capital. First of all, cash is current assets, debtors current assets, marketable security current assets, creditors current liabilities, bills receivable current assets, advance income current liabilities, bank overdraft current liabilities, accrued income current assets, prepaid expenses current assets. Now go for the calculation. Cash current assets, debtors security, bills receivable, bank balance, accrued income and prepaid expenses. Total of these are 5,16,000. Now go for the current liabilities. Under the current liabilities, there are creditors, advance income, and bank overdraft. These are the current liabilities. Total of these liabilities are 3,80,000. After finding out current assets and the current liabilities, now put the value on this formula: current assets divided by current liabilities. Now current ratio is 5,16,000 of the current assets and 3,80,000 of the current liabilities. After dividing, its answer is 1.46:1. Because its standard ratio is 2:1, it is less than 2:1. So we can say company is not in good position of current assets and current liabilities. Now go for the working capital. The formula of the working capital is current assets minus current liabilities. It is the formula of the working capital. And we have current assets 5,16,000 and current liabilities 3,80,000. After deducting 3,80,000 from 5,16,000, we have 1,36,000. Now it is the complete part of the question. Now, second part of the liquidity ratio is liquid ratio. It is also known quick ratio and acid test ratio. It is used to test very short-term solvency or liquidity position of the company. Liquid assets are cash and cash equivalent. Cash equivalent means the assets which can be converted into 90 days. They are known cash equivalent. Its standard is 1:1 in quick assets is to current liabilities. Quick ratio is also called liquid ratio and acid test ratio. Its formula is quick assets divided by current liabilities. And to find out the quick assets, first of all, we find out the current assets. From the current assets, we deduct stock and prepaid expenses. Here, stock means inventory. Now go for the next illustration. The following information is given by XYZ company. Bank overdraft, current liabilities, accounts payable, current liabilities, prepaid expenses, current assets, accounts receivable, current assets, outstanding expenses, current liabilities, inventory, current assets, cash, current assets, trade investment, current assets. From these transactions, we can easily find out the current assets. Now go for the current assets. Current assets, prepaid expenses, account receivable, inventory, cash, trade expenses. After adding all the current assets, we have 2 lakh rupees. Now go for the current liabilities, bank overdraft, accounts payable, outstanding expenses. After adding, we have 1 lakh. Now, quick assets. Quick assets formula is current assets minus prepaid or minus inventory. So, current assets 2 lakh, prepaid is 20,000 and inventory or stock is 60,000. After deducting 1,20,000. You can directly find out quick assets after leaving the prepaid expenses and inventory. Now go for the formula. Current ratio. Formula of the current ratio is current assets divided by current liabilities. Current assets is 2 lakh and current liabilities is 1 lakh after dividing 2:1. Quick ratio, formula of quick ratio is quick assets divided by current liabilities. And quick assets is 1,20,000 and current liabilities is 1 lakh after dividing 1:2:1. So students, this is very simple problem of the ratio analysis, and I have tried to adjust the all the transaction of current asset and current liabilities. Solve the problem of your textbook. If you face any difficulties, you can write down on comment box. Thank you. Thank you for investing your time. If you liked the video, turn black like button into blue. Suggest me on comment box. Subscribe my channel and help me. Thank you.